Hello dear student, today we are discussing about Teratophyta. Okay, we are considering chapter number 3, that is plant kingdom. In plant kingdom, in early videos we are discussing about algae, bryophytas. Okay, now today's class we are discussing about Teratophyta. So in this class we are start our topic, that is Teratophyta. Generally if we talk about Teratophyta, Teratophyta is a Greek word. Okay, which means pterons and phytons. Pterons means fern and phytons means plant. That means fern-like plant is called Teratophyta. In all over the world, there are total 10,000 species of Teratophyta are present on the earth. Okay, if we talk about Teratophyta, Teratophyta is complete or well-developed plant. Their body is divided into true stems, true leaves, true root. Okay, now see, there is a different varieties and species of Teratophyta are present in on the earth. Every have their own type of reproduction and own type of life cycles. If we talk about the life cycle of Teratophyta, generally alternate generations are seen. There is two types, heterogeneous types. Heterogeneous, that means their histological morphology are different and they reproduce by the process of heterogamy. Now, general characters. Okay, now we are discussing the general character of Teratophyta. See, I am already told you that Teratophyta, those plant which body is fern like, that means their body is look like a fern or feather shaped. Now their body is divided into true root, true stem and true leaves. That means their body is completely developed. They have advantageous root. It means which type of root is present in Teratophyta? Advantageous type of root are present in it. The root has a permanent growing part. Okay, all the vegetative part possess a vascular tissue. That means all the vegetative part possess a vascular tissue. The leaves may be small or micropyles or large microphyllums are present. All the vegetative part possess a vascular tissue. The spore and the germination to the produce haploid gametes called the prothallus. That means what is prothallus? Prothallus, the spore germinated to produce haploid gamete. That haploid gamete is called prothallus. Reproduction is occur by a spore. That means which type of reproduction it occur? That means the reproduction is occur due to the spores. Now the plant are homosporous. That means there is a lot of number of spores are present and all spores are same. So they are called homosporous. But in some plant the heterosporous are also present. That means the male spore and female spore both are different to each other. That is called heterospores. Now the spore germination to produce, I am already told about that, the spore germination produced to the haploid gamete called the prothallus. The sexual reproduction is occur by oogamous. Okay, which type of sexual reproduction occur? That is oogamous. The male sex organ is antheridium and the female sex organ are archegonium. Both the organ are present in it. Okay, that means male gamete are separate and the female gamete are separate. Fertilization is occur in the presence of water. Fertilization is occur in the presence of water. Now the which type of life cycle we saw the alternation of generation of heterologous type. Okay, the diploid zygote is retained within the archegonia ventrally and it developed into the embryo with a remaining part attached to the gametophyte and get nourished during the either stage of the development. Okay, this all are the general character of Teratophyta. Write down in your notebook. about Moses and Fern are amphibians of plant kingdom. That means why Moses and ferns are called the amphibian of plant kingdom. State the stratification. Now the Moses that means bryophyta and ferns that means they are pteridophyta. The fundamental they are terrestrial plant, but they are depend on the external source of the free water for completing of their life cycle. That means their life cycle are complete in land as well as water. Okay, their life cycle are completed in land. That's why that means they live in a terrestrial region. But at the time of fertilization, their fertilization is complete in under the water. Okay, the external water is archegonia, open into archegonial neck, and the movement of anthroids into the archegonia that help in the animal to reproduce in a plant kingdom. All the amphibians are generally amphibian. That means those who live in land and who live in water, they complete their life cycle in both the region. That means in a land and or in the water. That's why the Moses and Fern complete their life cycle in the both region. That's why it is called amphibians of the plant kingdom. Okay, I hope so you could clear that topic. I am repeating again this topic. The Moses and Ferns, they complete their life cycle on the land as well as on the water. That's why amphibians are called amphibians of the plant. Moses and Ferns are called the amphibian of plant kingdom. And that means at the time of reproduction or at the time of fertilization, it occur in the water, and remaining life are completed in the land. Okay, so now we are discussing about the type of pteridophyta. Some common example of pteridophyta. Okay, now we are discussing about some common example of pteridophyta. Firstly, we discuss about the Lycopodium. Lycopodium is commonly known as club Moses. Okay, the common name of Lycopodium is club Moses. The species of Lycopodium show a wide range in the growth and the formation of sporophyte. Most of the species possess a green photosynthetic stem covered by a small scale-like leaves. These leaves are smaller and micropylous, which give rise areoles, and some of the aerial bunches bear a sporangium. Interterminal cluster called the strobiles. These strobiles are the club shaped, that why it is called club Moses. Now we are discussing the next one, that is Selaginella. Selaginella is commonly known as spike moss. Okay, why it is called spike moss? Most of the species of this Selaginella group is damp and poorly alienated forest floor. A few species occur in temperature region in moist and stand hilly areas. A few species, however, grow in the external xerophytic areas and condition in the desert. Some species are solid in the mark and novellate. The plant are capable to flexible branch. When the Selaginella is an important pteridophyta because of the heterospores, so they consider as a, such plant are considered as a recurrection plant. Okay, so they are called recurrection plant, and the small spike like structure are seen in it. That's why it is called spike Moses. The next one we are talking about the Equisetum. Equisetum is also commonly known as storing rushes. What we call is scoring rushes. See, scoring rushes grow along the bank of river in the sandy and swampy soil. Some species grow along the sandy soil or railways near to railway lines. Plants are generally pre-annual live in a pre-annual habitat or herbs. The undergoes they developed aerial branches which arise from the nodes. The generally they are erect in shape. Spores are homosporangium and germinate to produce independence and cushing like a gametophyte. Now we are discussing the fourth example, that is fern. Now if we talking about the fern are widely distributed and knowing in all over the world. They live in the warm, moist and shady places. The main plant body of fern of saprophytes are differentiated into underground stems, shoot system with the leaves. Leaves may be simple or compound, usually large and micropylous. Generally, they arise alternate and upper side of the rhizomes. Generally, ferns are homosporous or heterosporous in nature. Spores are become inside the sporangia, which are grounded or grouped in the spores. Generally, some more common example of ferns are that is petrels. Okay, this is the example of fern. Other than that, Pteridium is also the example of fern. Now, Azolla is also an example of pteridophyta, that is commonly called water ferns. This is the common example of pteridophyta. Now we are discussing about the economical importance of pteridophyta. Now we are discussing about eco importance of pteridophyta. See, the first one, it is used as a ornamental value. Ornamental value, that means many ferns are grow ornamental plant in a garden for the large and slow a graceful foliage. Next one, medicine. It also show a medicinal value. Okay, it also used as a medicines. That means, it is used as a drug. It is used to obtain a drug in the petioles of the fern. That means the petioles of the fern used to produce a drugs. The disorder of lungs and kidney is solved by the preparing of medicine by the ferns. Now the third one is food. It also used as a food. Some pteridophyta species we use as a food because they are rich source of starch and it has lot of nutrition value. These are the common economic importance in our daily life of pteridophyta. In our topic, pteridophyta is finished. Now in our next session we are discussing about the gymnosperms. Okay, now in our next topic we are discussing about gymnosperms. So class, please make their on root notes on pteridophyta. Okay, I hope so you are capable to understand the pteridophyta. In next class we are discussing about gymnosperm. Till then, have a nice day.